Hello and welcome to this new Jorgensen webinar, this time about our new vacuuming and gassing system. My name is Simon Toft. I'm head of projects here at Jorgensen. And with me, I have invited Morten Larsen.
Welcome, Simon. Morten.
Hi. Morten is our resident expert in the vacuuming and gassing cycle. So Morten knows a lot about this issue and will help out in explaining some of the cool new features that we'll be demonstrating here. Morten, without further ado, let's jump into it. We have made these systems for a long time now. What is the reason for now improving and going to the next generation?
So we did a lot of market research among our customers and trying to evaluate on what improvements the customers wanted to make this product better. And what we figured was that they wanted to reduce the footprint of the equipment. We wanted to improve the hygiene of the system, and also we wanted to go to an all stainless steel system instead of a mild painted steel version.
That makes sense to me. Why, you mentioned the stainless steel and the smaller footprint, why is that important to our customers?
So the reason why we want to reduce the footprint is to make it easier for us and for the customer to fit this system into an existing factory, and ultimately you can make a smaller high care area, which at the end saves cost for the customer. And also, if we look to the hygiene, it's easier cleanability, makes it easier for the customer to do a quick cleaning and make sure that the product is safe in a quick and easy way.
I think that makes perfect sense to me. You know, when we're on site talking with the customers, these are the things we always hear. They ask us, well, how do you expect us to clean this? And I can see there's been put a lot of thought into this. Also the high care, the footprint, I mean, at the end of the day, it comes down to cost.
Exactly.
So if we can minimize that area, perfect, less expense for the customer.
Yeah. And actually we do have a video that we can show you where you can see overall how the system looks, and I think we'll just put that on and let it talk for itself.
Let's see here. You can actually already see the improvements on the visibility for the operators compared to the older generation. I think the visibility is a lot better now than it used to be.
Yeah. But you see the cans entering the gassing unit and the new cans coming in.
I think that in general the design is a bit more space age now than the more traditional industrial look that it had before.
It's not as square as it used to be.
Yeah, exactly.
And here now the cans are entering the outfeed where it's in a gassed environment. Putting the product into a single line, ready for the next machine down the line.
If there's a bit about cleanability in this one, I see as well, Morten, I see the new door here is a different design than what we're used to.
Yeah, exactly.
I think we'll get back to the cleanability and the access in a second.
Yeah, we'll show a bit more about that in detail a bit later in the webinar. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm just gonna close this down then, because what I was wondering is, now I know what the customer gets, but when they order a vacuuming gassing system, what do they actually get? Is it just the box by itself, or what goes along with it in the delivery?
When you buy the vacuum and gassing system, you get more than just the gassing unit itself. You can try and pull up a picture where we see an overview. And here you can see in just a moment that we have the infeed on the right side that you saw in the video. Here the cans are collated. Then you have the gassing unit in the middle, and then you have a gas tight outfeed on the left side. On top of this, what you don't see in the picture, you also get a mixer for mixing the gas, you get a tank for holding the gas, and you get some vacuum pumps for pumping down the pressure inside the gassing unit. And then, of course, there's also a service wagon to take out the conveyors in the gassing unit if necessary for cleaning.
Yep, I have a few more pictures that I'd like to show, actually, if you could put a few words on that.
So Simon already mentioned a little bit about the improved access and cleanability of the system. And what you see here on the picture is that we have increased the size of the doors. This is the infeed we are looking at. It's very open, easy to reach, easy to clean, and also easy to see what's happening when the operator is just looking at a glance.
Yeah, I think that's a huge improvement. And I actually have one more I'd like to show. I think this one.
So here you're looking inside the gas tight outfeed after the gassing unit. And as you can see, it's a very clean, simple design, very open, and very easy surfaces to clean. It's very straight surfaces, no nicks and crannies that anything can get stuck in.
Yeah, I think the new design for the hatches is really neat.
Yeah.
Compared to the older ones. I mean, the area is much bigger now.
The area is bigger. There's more light coming in because it's one big polycarbonate plate instead of a partial steel plate.
Okay.
For the doors.
Yeah. Oh, that makes sense. Just close this picture down because we talked a little bit about cleanability, and this is the main issue I hear from my customers is that they have downtime due to cleaning. So how do we minimize the cleaning?
Exactly. So this is, as I mentioned, one of the things that came up during our market research that the customers, they want to improve the cleanability. So as we mentioned, we have made the complete system in stainless steel. It's a Vivatec treatment, which is very smooth and very easy to clean. We have a video also we can show where you see how to clean the gassing unit. And we'll just pull it up. Just 1 second.
Yeah, I think it's this one. I'm going to try to pause it while Morten talks if he has important points to make during this.
Yeah. So here you see the overall system. And first, our colleague is dismounting or disconnecting the unit. You have to disconnect the gas and the vacuum and also the electrical part. Then you can pull out the unit on some rails that we put on the floor to access the inside of the gassing unit itself. And here, if you just pause it for a minute, we have the drive shaft driving the conveyors inside the gassing unit. And this you have to pull out in order to take out the conveyors themselves. Continue here.
Now I can see Brian in the video here, our production guy. It seems there's a handle now he's pulling. Is that a new thing as well? Is that to make it more operator friendly, or what's the reasoning there?
Exactly. It's to make it easier to handle with with just the normal tools and just taking it out by hand instead of having to use a lot of special tools for it.
Okay.
And then here you see Brian is removing the diffusers. This is also a new part that we have improved on these gassing units. It's a much bigger diffuser, making sure that we get an even spread of gas inside the gassing unit.
Okay.
So they have to be pulled out in order for us to take out the conveyors. So now we just pause it again. We have the service wagon on the floor, which follows the delivery, and you can pull out the conveyors on this service wagon, and this is what Brian is doing here. You can continue.
Mm-hmm.
It's very easy. Even though the conveyors are a little heavy, you don't have to lift anything. They just roll out. And then here, to access the rear side of the doors at either end, you can actually tilt them out, and then you get open access on the back side so you can make sure that you can clean all the surfaces easily.
I think this is maybe my favorite part in the new solution. I mean, it's a huge design improvement compared to our older generation.
Yeah. The older generation, it was a bit of a hassle to get to the back side. You have to lift everything up with a special system and mechanism, and here you just have to tilt it out.
Yeah, I think that's really good and something the customers will appreciate, especially the operators. And then this is then the stainless steel solution?
Exactly. This is the stainless steel solution. You see inside the gassing unit without the conveyors, it's a very open room. You can easily clean all the surfaces with a vacuum, as Brian is doing here.
Okay. Yeah. And what you talked about the treatment, that it's very smooth.
Yeah.
What is the main difference compared to the older generation?
So normally in the older generations, we were using a mild steel painted solution where you have a painted surface. And of course, this is also a smooth solution on the surface. But the risk is that if the paint gets a chip or something like that, it can risk and fall off, which of course we don't want.
Okay.
What you see here is now the outfeed, the gas tight areas, where we've also made a lot of improvement for the cleanability. So now when you want to clean inside, you can actually remove the surface that the conveyor is running on, which means you get a very good access to the inside of the complete tunnel and not just the surface on the conveyor.
Mm-hmm. You can also see the new hatches here, the new system that it's actually the, I guess, polycarbonate or Lexan solution with no metal edges around it.
Exactly. You can see here the open area that you get from removing the plate. Yeah, I think that's the cleanability.
Yeah. Okay, so we talked about cleanability, we talked about smaller footprint, we talked about stainless steel. What other features are there now in the new generation?
So one of the other major improvements that we did is regarding the actual vacuum and gassing cycle, that we have changed the controls of this to a regulating valve. So instead of just pumping down in steps and gassing in steps, now we're able to control it infinitely with a regulating valve. This means that you can make an individual recipe for each different type of powder that you're running, and you can customize this to what the customer needs.
I think that's really cool. I think that's a really good feature of the new generation, that we can actually customize now the gassing cycle to the density and the airiness, whatever, of the product.
Exactly. So you can gain more speed if you have a very stable product. And then you can run quicker. And if you have a more difficult product, we can also tailor suit our system to handle this.
Okay, that makes sense to me. And I'm sure the customers will appreciate this feature as well.
I hope so.
In summary, Morten, three reasons for choosing the new vacuuming and gassing system.
So I would say definitely the main three reasons for choosing this new system will be the reduced footprint, making it more space efficient. It will be the improved hygienic design with the all stainless steel, and it will be the product safety and efficiency of the production system.
Okay. Well, Morten, I think that about wraps it up. Thank you for joining me in explaining this new
You're
system.
Welcome.
Yep. For you, our dear audience, thank you for joining in and having a look at our new generation of the BTS. Please stay tuned to our social media. We are on Twitter, YouTube, you name it. And also don't hesitate to contact us for a virtual reality presentation of our new systems, should you be interested. Thank you very much for now. Bye-bye.